Hi, and welcome to this video on automating your approval processes in Zoho CRM. For most businesses, approvals are crucial in sales to mandate certain things based on organization policies, say your discount percentage or a campaign budget. Zoho CRM helps with automating the submission of records for approval by specifying criteria based on which records will be sent for approval. You can also include a set of actions to follow automatically based on the approval or rejection of the records. Let's look at a specific example. Zilker Inc. is a sales organization that is into selling multiple products B2B. As per the company's policy, the sales reps are allowed to give a discount of up to only 10% during the negotiation stage. Anything beyond 10% would call for approval from the manager and the sales director. Based on the deal size and the purchase history, the approvers would choose to approve or reject the discount requested by the customer. Now let's look at how Zilker can mandate this by using an approval process in Zoho CRM. Once logged in, go to Setup, Automation, Approval Processes. In the Approval Process List page, click the Add Approval Process button right here. In the New Approval Process page, select the module for which you want to add the approval process for. In our case, it's for deals, and let's call it Discount Approval. Add a description, say, for approval from manager and sales director to confirm higher discounts. You can choose to trigger the approval process for when a record is created or edited. In our case, it's going to be both. Now click the New Rule to this Process button. There are four important steps that will help you define the approval process and possible actions to follow. First comes the rule criteria, then who should approve, then actions upon approval, and lastly, actions upon rejection. Notice that you cannot skip over any of these steps. So let's get started. Under rule criteria, the sales rep requires an approval on deals when the discount is more than 10%. So choose discount is greater than 10%. You can add multiple conditions to this criteria by clicking the plus icon right here. For example, you can also choose a specific product for which you want to apply this process. Notice that you can also edit the and/or pattern for this rule criteria here, or in case you want to do it manually, right here. Moving on, under who should approve, you can select between users, roles, groups, levels, or manager from the drop-down right here. Let's select levels, up to two levels. Based on the role hierarchy, the respective deal owner's sales manager and sales director would be involved for each rep. When you opt for more than one approver, you choose between anyone or everyone. Let's choose everyone. The record is now considered to be approved only when all the users approve. Next, specify the order of approval between sequential or parallel. Let's stick to parallel approval where all the users can approve the record simultaneously. By selecting this Assign Task option, you can assign a task to the immediate approver. Let's create a task called Approve Discount, set the due date as 2 days until record submission, and update the status as not started with High Priority. Let's also choose to notify and remind assignee through pop-up and hit save and associate. Moving on to the next step under action upon approval, you can choose to update fields of the record with each approval. In our case, let's update the deal stage field for the first approval as discount accepted and for the second approval as discount approved. You can also configure actions upon final approval, such as assign a task, send an email notification, call webhooks, or custom functions. Let's add a follow-up task for the deal owner to call the customer and confirm the payment details. Next, select the email notification and choose the discount approved email template to be sent to the deal owner and the associated contact. This way, once the discount gets the final approval, an email is automatically sent to the concerned sales rep as well as the customer communicating the same. So let's move on to actions upon rejection. Similar to actions upon approval, you can configure certain actions to be automated if the discount has been rejected. The only difference is that you cannot assign a task. So let's go ahead and set up an email notification to be sent when the discount gets rejected. You can choose to send email to the requester's manager, everyone who approved the record, or to both. Next, to select a template to be sent to the requester, let's choose Discount Rejected Template and then hit Associate. Let's also choose the stage field to be updated accordingly. When you click Done, you can see a summary of the entire approval process that we just defined. You can click and make any changes if required. Once your assurance is good to go, click Save. Going forward, this process will automatically be applied for deals when the discount value exceeds 10%, as we specified earlier. Okay, now let's look at the approval process in action. I'm now logged in as Tai Chang, a sales rep who reports to Martha Hills, the sales manager, who then in turn reports to Quinn Rivers, the sales director here at Zilker. Consider this deal for 700 widgets from Arizona Inc. Now that the deal is in the negotiation stage, let me go ahead and update the discount field with 20% as requested by the customer and save. This record has now been locked and is waiting for approval from Martha Hills and Quinn Rivers. Since we opted for parallel approval, both Martha and Quinn can approve the record simultaneously without waiting for each other's approval. Coming back to this deal, tasks are automatically created based on the approval process. Now, being locked essentially means that no one will be able to convert, edit, or delete this deal, and none of the CRM automation rules will be applied until it gets approved or rejected. Let's now look at how a manager approves this record. So I'm now logged in as Martha Hills, the sales manager. Records that are awaiting approval can be accessed from the My Jobs tab. You can click the dropdown to select and view records only from Blueprint, Only Approval Process, or All. Let's select Only Approval Process. And you can see the deal for 700 widgets is right here for approval. You can see the name of the record, the module, record owner, when was the record initiated for approval, whether it was from Blueprint or Approval Process, and the Reject Approve actions. You can click open the record to view more details about the deal in case something like reading the deal notes could help you in deciding approval or rejection. So let's go ahead and approve the discount. Once Quinn Rivers also approves the record, an email is automatically sent to Tai Chang, the sales rep, as well as the contact. And as you can see right here, the record is now unlocked, so you can convert and close the deal as one. Note that since the approval was parallel, Quinn did not have to wait for Martha to approve. When you have more than one approval process for a module, the system checks if a record matches the criteria for an approval process in the same order in which it's listed, which is the same order in which it was created. So for example, we created an approval process called discount approval for deals with a criteria discount greater than 10%. When we create another approval process called discount approval 2, for deals with a greater discount than 25%, it gets listed after the first one that we created. When a deal asks for a discount of 30%, you'd want it to follow discount approval 2, but based on the listing, it will actually first follow discount approval 1, which we created first. In such cases, you may need to reorder the processes based on priority. So let's see how. Go to Setup, Automation, Approval Processes. In the Approval Process List page, click the Module Header dropdown and select the module which process execution sequence you want to reorder. Let's select Deals. Click Reorder Processes. You can now simply drag and drop to reorder the list and then save. Similarly, you can also drag and drop the multiple rules of criteria to reorder them the way you want them to be followed. And there you have it. By automating approval processes in Zoho CRM, you can negotiate and close deals faster without the back and forth emails or calls with your managers and leads. Thank you so much for watching this video. For more resources on Zoho CRM, please visit us at www.zoho.com/crm/resources.